Good morning. After a long time, I'm going to shoot a video for class 7 ICSE, and the chapter is Atoms, Molecules, and Radicals. We'll try to understand these three topics in this chapter. So, as we know that atom constitutes matter. And what is matter? Matter is anything that occupies space, have mass, and can be perceived by our senses. Senses means, you know that there are five senses, and that can be perceived. That is called matter. Everything is matter. Eye matter, fan matter, pencil is matter, table is matter. So we can say that everything is matter. In this chapter, we'll try to understand what is atom first. As we know that atom is the smallest part which exists independently. It means it exists in free state. It can't be divided. It means or any process, or by any means, you can't be divided into pieces. So we can say it is indivisible. Indivisible. It can't be break into other substance. It can take part in chemical reaction. We'll see the chemical reactions in the next or higher classes. What is chemical reactions and how it takes place? How atoms takes part in chemical reaction, that these answers you'll get in higher classes. So simply in your label in class 7, you have to know that what is atom. So you can say that atom is the smallest part of an element which takes part in chemical reaction, which is indivisible. Now we'll move to the next point in this chapter. We'll try to understand valency. So a very important topic. What is valency? There are two types of definition given. First is old definition, and one more is given, that is called modern definition of valency. So we'll try to understand what is modern definition of valency. In periodic table, there are 118 plus elements exist, and day by day their numbers are increasing, and each element or each atoms attain to octet structure. You can say it wants to achieve octet structure. Octet structure is stable structure. So every element wants to be in stable form. And for that, they lose electrons, they gain electrons, or they share electrons, by which they can get the stability, or they become stable. So valency you can define as the tendency of an atom. The tendency of an atom, or you can say another way, you can say the number of electron, or you mention that valence electron, the number of valence electron is, or electrons then are, the number of valence electron or electrons are shared by, transferred by, or gains by an atom to complete the octet structure, that is known as valency of the respective elements. Once again, I'm going to repeat, the number of electron or electrons shared by, transferred by, or you can say lose by, and gained by an atom to complete the octet structure or stable configuration, that is known valency of that element. As for example, hydrogen, its atomic number is 1, its valence electron is 1. And this is the exception. This is an exception. You can say that hydrogen wants to get duplet structure. Duplet means it wants to achieve or get helium configuration. Helium configuration means it should have 2 electrons in their outermost shell. This is the exception. Hydrogen wants to achieve helium configuration. Helium configuration, it means helium has 2 electrons in the outermost shell. So hydrogen also wants to have 2 electrons in its shell, and then it becomes stable. You can see that hydrogen having how many electrons? 1. It means it need 1 more electron, and for that it may share or it may lose. Why I'm saying lose? Because hydrogen is an exception and it shows dual nature. Dual nature means it shows nature like metal as well as light non-metal. It means it can lose also and it can gain also. In class 8, you will study the chapter hydrogen, and there you will get answer why hydrogen is placed in alkali group as well as in halogen group. So hydrogen need 1 electron to complete the duplet structure. So it will share 1 electron with other atom. This is why we can say its valency is 1. We can take another element as, for example, sodium. Sodium is an element and its atomic number is 11. Okay, and its valence electron, its valence electron is equal to 1. How? In detail you will study in class 8. Just I am giving a little information why valence electron is 1. Because its electronic configuration is 2, 8, 1. How I have written configuration 2, 8, 1? I'm going to explain. As we know, atom structure is like a sphere, like a spherical. And at the center of an atom, nucleus is present. What is present? Nucleus. So here at the center, nucleus is present. And in nucleus, protons as well as neutrons are present. And proton carry positive charge, that's why I have written a P plus, and neutron carry no charge, that's why written N zero. And here that's why I have written plus sign, because at the center means in nucleus, what will be the sign? The sign is positive. Means we can say that nucleus is positively charged. Yes, right? Now, around the nucleus, this is nucleus, around the nucleus there are many spherical cells, and that cells are notified by different names, and this also will get in detail study in class 8. Just I'm giving here the introduction so that you can easily understand valency and valence electron. The cell which is near to the nucleus, closer to the nucleus, that cell is named K cell, and then after cell is called L cell, then is M cell, and then is N cell. And in these all cells, electrons are present. What are present? Electrons. And electrons carry negative charge. So this is the sign that showing electron is negatively charged particle. Electron, proton and neutrons are called fundamental particles of an atom. These are why called fundamental particles, because these are forming an atom. So that's why these are called fundamental particles. Must remember, question can come, what are fundamental particles? So electron, proton and neutron are the fundamental particles of an atom. Like for making bricks or making house, we need like iron rod, bricks, concrete. These are called fundamental particles of buildings. Similarly, these electron, proton and neutrons are called fundamental particles of an atom. Electrons revolve around the nucleus in a circular path. Circular path. One more thing you have to know, that K cell can keep 2 electrons. How many electrons? 2 electrons. It has tendency to keep only 2 electrons, not more than that. It can keep less than 2, but not more than 2 electrons. So you must remember, it keeps 2 electrons. In short, I have written E to denote electron. And L cell can keep how many electrons? 8 electrons. M cell, it can also keep 8 electrons. N cell, it can also keep 8 electrons. It has tendency to keep more electrons, but maximum it can keep 8 to become stable. For stability, these cells L, M, N, there must be 8 electrons, not more than that. It may keep more than 8, but what I'm saying, for stability, there should be 8 electrons. And the same concept I have applied for writing electronic configuration of sodium. So here 11, we can say this is Z. Z is atomic number. How much? 11. One more thing I am writing here. Suppose X is an element. X is denoting an element. Here is Z, here is A. Here Z is denote. What is? It denotes atomic number. Okay? And here A denotes atomic mass, or you can also say mass number. One more thing I want to tell you here. Here Z is equal to proton, which is also equal to electron, as well as A is equal to atomic mass is equal to proton, which is present in nucleus, plus neutron, which is also present in nucleus. Or you can also say N naught is equal to A minus P, as we know P is equal to Z. So you can write here A minus Z. So from here you can find neutron. And as we saw, proton is equal to atomic number, and which is also equal to number of electrons which revolve around the nucleus. So we'll try to understand how to write electronic configuration. You can see how many total electrons here. You can say electron is 11, and how many protons are here is also 11, as according to this concept. If we start writing configuration for sodium, we can say how many electrons? 11. And for writing electronic configuration, if we look electron, how many electrons are there? You can see that there are 11 electrons. So these electrons revolve around the nucleus in shell, and shells are K, L, M, N. So first electrons will get into K cell, and then L and then M, and last we will go to N. There are so many cells, but here you have to see till N. So again, I'm going to explain K cell, L cell, M cell, three cells. So K cell can keep how many electrons? Two. Retain how many total electrons? We have 11. Don't go more than that. How many? 11. So we have written two. Rest are 9. So again, we'll go to the L cell. How many electrons can keep? 8. So we write here 8. 8 plus 2, 10 is retained. Still one electron is left. It has tendency to keep how many electrons? 8. But how many electrons are left to write for sodium in cell? One electron is left because already we have written 10. So it will be 1. And this cell, the outer, this is the outer, this is the inner cell. That side is called outer cell. And this outer cell is called valence shell. Outer cell is called valence shell. And how many electrons are there? This is the electron 1, and this electron is called valence electron. So I hope I'm clear what is valence electron. Well, valence electron is 1, sodium valence electron is 1. Okay, so we can say that the number of electrons present in outermost shell, the number of valence cell, this is called outermost cell also you can say. So the number of electron is 1, so its valence cell containing 1 electron, so we can say sodium valence electron is 1. Okay, and valency, what is valency? If valence electron is 1, 2, 3, if valence electron is 1, 2, 3, its valency will be also 1, 2, and 3 respectively. I hope I am clear with the topic valency and valence electron. So it will lose or gain, it will lose 1 electron. After losing, it becomes 2 and 8. So it becomes stable. So sodium will lose 1 electron. So its valency is 1. Once again, the number of electrons an atom is losing or sharing or gaining, that is called valency of the respective elements. So it is losing 1, so its valency is how much? Its valency, we can say its valency is 1. Okay, its valency is 1. We'll see the more example to understand valency and valence electron. So you can say that here, if valence electron is equal to 1, 2, 3, then their valency will be 1, 2, or 3. You can use here or 3 respectively. It means if valence electron is 1, its valency is 1. If valence electron is 2, its valency is 2. If valence electron is 3, its valency is 3. And if they possess valence electron 1, 2, 3, these elements are metals. Those elements possess valence electron 1, 2, 3, then their valency will be 1, 2, 3 respectively, and they supposed to be metal. One more thing you can say, that metals lose valence electron, metal lose valence electron to attain or maintain the stability. Okay, so this is the concept of valency and valence electron for metals. Now we'll see for the non-metals. For example, we'll take and we'll try to understand. We'll take one more example, chlorine. Chlorine atomic number is 17, that it means you have to learn up to 20. Atomic number up to 20, it is given in your book. In this same chapter, you have to learn up to 20. Atomic number of chlorine is 17, so we'll try to write first Z. How much Z will be? Surely 17, right? Then how much proton? As we know, Z is equal to P, so it is also 17. And also we know that electron is equal to number of proton, so it is also 17. Yeah. So we'll write electronic configuration. In short, we can write EC, electronic configuration. Try to write. So first we'll go in K cell, then L cell, okay, then M cell. Now try to fill electrons. In K cell, how many can? Total, you must remember, total electron you have only 17, not will not exceed more than 17 while writing the electronic configuration, because we are writing for chlorine. Now next cell is L cell. What is the capacity? 8. I'll put here. Now I have here how many total? 10. How many are left now? 7 more. Which is the next cell? M cell. What is the capacity? 8. But how many electrons are left to write for chlorine now is 7. So right here, 7. So as we know that this is the outermost shell, that is also called valence cell. It is also called valence cell. And how many electrons are present in the valence cell? You can see there are 7 electrons. So we can say valence electron is equal to 7. Okay, so this way you can write valence electron. Now you can see that, as I said, that each element wants to get 8 electrons in their outermost shell. You can see how many electrons in its outermost shell? 7. So it need one more electron, so it will lose or gain. It will gain electron. So can we say non-metal gain electrons? If it is gaining one electron, and as I said, the definition of valency, the tendency of an atom to lose, share or gain electrons to complete the structure, octet structure, that is called its valency. So how many it is gaining? It is gaining one. So we can say that chlorine valency will be 1. How much? Chlorine valency will be 1. Similarly, you can find out valency as well as valence electron up to 20. I'm going to give one table, and that work you have to do till up to 20. You have to write the valence electron, you have to write valency, you have to find out which is metal and which is non-metal. That work you have to do, and then I will end this topic here, and in the next video I'll deal what is molecule. So here atom and valency as well as valency will be getting over. I'm giving one work and that you have to do. In first column you have to write atomic number, that is denoted by J. Then you have to write elements name. What you have to write? Elements name. In the third column you have to write symbol for all elements. You have to write symbol. What element you are writing? You have to write the symbol. The next column we have to write Z already written. You have to write here protons. How many protons that have? Then you have to write electron harmony it has, and then you have to write electronic configuration. In electronic configuration, you have to make four rows: K cell, a sub column, L cell, then M cell, and then N cell. These are the sub columns of electronic configuration. And at the last, you have not last the three more columns. Next column, you have to write valency. I'm writing in the sort. What is the valency? You can write first valence electron, and then you write valency. And the last column, you have to write. There is no space. The sum is dictating. In the last column, you have to identify it is metal or it is non-metal. In sort, I have written metal. You can give also the sort form for metal M and for the non-metal NM. This is your work, and that you have to do. You have to write up to 20, 1 to 20 serial wise. One, it is given in your book, but some columns it is not given, that I have explained just now. You have to follow what concept I have given. If valence electron is 1, what will be the valency, and is it metal or non-metal? Once again, I'm going to repeat. If valence electron is 1, 2, 3, valence electron 1, 2 or 3, they will be metal except helium. Its valence electron is 2, but it is inert gas, it is non-metal. Hydrogen is a metal, it possesses both nature, metallic as well as non-metallic nature. Once again, the valence electron, if an element have 1 or 2 or 3, they will be metals except helium. Okay. And otherwise, if not fulfilling these three valence electron, then rest will be non-metals. So you have to do this work in your copy. And I hope I'm clear with the topic valency, valence electron, and definition of atom. So very soon I'm going to give another video that is for molecules, and one more video that I will provide for the same chapter, and that is for radicals. So I hope I'm clear. So you have to do your work, and thank you. Enjoy.